Hi everyone, today I'm going to show you how to make an SNS Screamin' Swing Ride in Open Roller Coaster Tycoon 2. I recently built one of these for my Cedar Point Recreation Park a couple episodes ago, and it was probably pretty hard to tell in the time lapse exactly how I did it, and it's a pretty quick and simple build, so I figured I would go through the process here a little bit and show you how it was done. So if you've ever built yourself an inverted impulse coaster, such as this pre-build, you're already halfway there. This is basically what we'll be doing, except with some different track types and different vehicle types and a little bit of hacking to get vehicles placed differently, but it's not too complicated. So let's get started. To get set up for this build, we're gonna need a few cheats enabled. We will use show operating modes, disable vehicle limits and show vehicles from other track types, and allow arbitrary ride type changes. We'll also be using Bassy's Ride Vehicle Editor plugin for this one, so make sure you have that downloaded if you don't already. There will be a link to that in the description below. I'm going to start by building a Twister coaster, because that's just the easiest thing for me to use. And I'm going to start with one station piece, and we're going to use a large slope up to a vertical, and then into a quarter loop for one half of our arc up, and then we'll do the same on the other side for our other half. I'll add an entrance and exit. I'll put them on the same tile just to save some space. Now for the vehicle, we're going to go with the floorless twister trains, and I'm going to just use one train, one car per train for right now, and I'll show you why in just a moment. And then for our operating mode, we're going to use powered launch passing station. This is the same mode that the inverted impulse coaster uses. And you can put as many circuits as you want on this, probably something like 5, 6, 7, whatever you like. As far as launch speed goes, this is also one that you'll have to play around with on your own, but probably something in the 40 to 60 mile per hour range is probably gonna be pretty good. And you can see our lonely little car here going back and forth on an arc. Of course, this is only half of the solution. We want to get two arms swinging in synchronization here. So we're going to do a little bit of track merging and hacking to get that to happen. So what I'm going to start with is deleting this slope up here. And then we're going to turn our ride into a steel wild mouse. Now you'll see the track disappears because the steel wild mouse doesn't have the large slopes that the twister does. And that's fine, they'll come back. And from our entrance, we're going to do two tiny turns and then one straight piece, and then we will switch back to Twister Roller Coaster. And from here, we'll do our large curves up again in our quarter loop. And switching back to Steel Wild Mouse, we'll need to delete this tiny corner. Switch back to Twister so we can build the other bit of the loop here. And we can also rebuild it on the original as well. Now we'll need to switch back to Steel Wild Mouse so we can rebuild the tiny curve. And now this should be all of our track pieces in place. And let's switch to two cars now. And we will go ahead and test and then immediately close the ride so that the vehicles will spawn but they won't go anywhere. Now let's open up our Ride Vehicle Editor plugin, and we're going to move the back car along the Steel Wild Mouse track that is currently invisible so that it is on the other side of the Twister track facing the other direction. Now to make sure this happens properly, we need to use the Tile Inspector to put the Steel Wild Mouse track below the Twister track in the order here, and just to verify that we can do that, if we raise and lower this piece that's here on top, we can see that's the Twister track, so that this track below it is the invisible Steel Wild Mouse track. And we'll do the same for the tile next door. And as I raise and lower this piece, nothing happens. And if I raise and lower the piece below it, we can see it moving. So that means we need to swap the order of these two. So what you should see happen now, if we go back to our Ride Vehicle Editor plugin and we select Vehicle 2, and we're going to move this track progress, and we should see the train go along the tiny turns, and now we can rest it right next to the first car. However, now we want it to stay on the twister track. So we can close our ride vehicle editor and open the tile inspector back up and reverse the order of these two track pieces. So now the Steel Wild Mouse track is on top, or you could just delete it either way so that the floorless coaster trains will only ride on the twister track. And if we test our ride, we should see that happen. And now we have two cars operating in synchronicity, moving back and forth in opposite directions, just as you would expect. Looks like our number of circuits has decreased. I'm gonna crank that back up. And we're basically done. The only thing that's left to do is some decoration. First, of course, we want to hide our track. And I'm gonna do that by changing this to any of our thrill rides that don't have track. Lately, I've been using Motion Simulator because it hides the track and gives slightly better stats than something like Unknown Ride, which can give often high intensities and low excitement. And next, I would like to move my entrance and exit so that they make a little bit more sense. I'm gonna put the exit over here by copying and pasting of the tile inspector and deleting the original. Or you could choose to hide these completely, whatever works for you. If you would like to build some supports for this, in the Cedar Point video, I used Inverted Impulse Train to build some vertical spikes upwards. Of course, there are a number of ways you can do this. If you wanted to, you could use something like Rotodrop Towers. It all depends on what you think looks best and what kind of supports you like. Of course, if you're doing something this way, you're probably going to want to move your entrance and exit so that guests won't be getting off the ride and immediately bonking their heads into the supports. And of course, don't forget to use the tile inspector to move these track pieces under the surface so that the supports won't be visible. Or if you don't care about that, you could just hide them with the no entrance station style. Finally, on my build, I also made some arms. And they are not going to move back and forth like the cars are. They're just there for display purposes. But it's nice to have them anyway. And for those, I use the single rail coaster to not only make the arms, but also the support that the arms are going to be hanging from. And just like the inverted impulse coaster for our main supports, you can simply make some vertical track here and have it go down to where the vehicles are going to rest. Of course, as you can see here, sometimes it can be a little difficult to get the alignment quite right, especially when you're dealing with vertical track pieces. So you may have to play around a little bit of different builds to see which alignments are going to work for you. In order to get the vertical pieces to interact correctly and intersect with the horizontal piece, I used a flat to gentle and then gentle to steep pieces rather than going straight from flat to steep. And of course, you can decorate further as needed. Let's also move these track pieces underneath this, above the surface, so that they don't look like they're being put in holes. And there you go. Quick little build, but pretty easy to do. Hope you found this helpful. If there's anything you'd like to see in the future, let me know in the comments.